So, you know, we get to the point where George is scheduled to come in, and I set it up on a day off. I wanted him to have complete undivided attention from me. My staff was prepped, and I'm fortunate I've got a great staff, and they were kind of waiting for him. And he walked in kind of bordering on a little bit of catatonic, nervous and scared, but he had a certain determined look on his face. And once I saw that look, I knew he would be fine. And, you know, we kind of went to work on him. We're in the about 3.5 hours worth of work. We did the both arches, top and bottom, at the same time. And, you know, there was some disease in there we had to control, and we, you know, did what we had to do to create the vision for me of what I wanted him to look like.
You did great. You really did awesome. It's just, I can't wait to see what he looks like. That's part of the whole thing.
You know, we do this all the time, but my assistant and I are kind of looking at it as we're doing it, and we're saying, wow, this is going to be great, you know. And we don't always, you know, it's kind of ho-hum to us sometimes, but this time around, we were vested in this mentally all the way, because we really wanted to, we were pushing for what he was going to see. And 3.5, 4 hours later, we finished up, and we kind of sat him up in the chair, and he was still kind of woozy a little bit, I think, just from the entire experience. And then his nerves, you know, what happens is you're so keyed up, and then when you start to relax a little bit, when you realize this is not going to be a painful event, you realize you're wide awake, you can communicate with us the whole time, then, you know, the end result of all these nerves makes people just, you know, almost dog tired. But, you know, he had a couple of minutes to sit up, and I said, all right, so what do you think? You want to take a look? He says, yeah. And we stood him up, walked him over to the mirror, and I helped him smile a little bit. He was still numb, but he was just blown away.